If you grew up in St. Paul, I bet you did roller derby, hockey games, concerts in this place. For decades, Roy Wilkins Auditorium has hosted events in downtown St. Paul, but many just don't know the history behind the building's name. Joe Mazin takes a look at a leader of the civil rights movement in this week's So Minnesota.
If the walls of this building could talk, they would tell you of hearing a prince, a king, and a guitar guy. Roy Wilkins Auditorium in downtown St. Paul has a legendary past. Just like the legendary man the building is named after.
Sadly, I don't think many people would know who Roy Wilkins was.
Professor Sam Imbo, Department Chair of Philosophy at Hamline University, knows the history of the prominent civil rights leader.
He was all about fighting inequalities.
Born in St. Louis in 1901, Wilkins grew up in St. Paul's Rondo neighborhood. After graduating from the University of Minnesota, he became an editor of an African-American newspaper.
The NAACP caught wind of what he was doing in Minnesota.
Wilkins was hired by the NAACP, eventually becoming its executive director. He called Martin Luther King a friend and took part in several notable marches of the civil rights movement.
He was part of the march from Selma to Montgomery. He was part of the march on Washington in 63. He witnessed the passing of the Civil Rights Act in 64. He witnessed the passing of the Voting Rights Bill in 65.
It could be a trend.
In 1967, President Lyndon Johnson awarded Wilkins the Presidential Medal of Freedom, the country's highest civilian honor.
His strategy was one of making change through legal means, going through the process. Having been raised in Minnesota, I think has a lot to do with it. You talk to people and try to make change that way.
Roy Wilkins passed away in 1981, but his legacy lives on here in Minnesota and across the nation.
Part of what he wanted was to lessen the inequality that he saw in growing up here and around the country and around the world.
In 1985, St. Paul Auditorium was renamed Roy Wilkins Auditorium. A memorial to the favorite son of Minnesota can be found near the front entrance. Performers that changed music have taken the stage here in a building named after a man who changed the world. In St. Paul, Joe Mazin, 5 Eyewitness News.
Wow, and you know, Joe Mazin, he always takes us around the state. He shows us a new piece of Minnesota just like that every single week that we didn't know about. By the way, if you've got ideas of where he should go next, he's ready to hear about them. Email us at nightcast@kstp.com.